everyone, and welcome to the last and final race of the 2013 EVO vs. SCI Championship. I'm your host, KRX, and with me once again for this monumental event, Windcharger. How you doing?
Doing pretty good. Excited to get this race on at the Nordschleife, longest track on the circuit, also known as the Green Hell, for a good reason, too.
And don't expect us to try to remember every twist and turn here. I guarantee you, I probably won't.
13-mile track, you're going to see a lot of turns where people are going to go for it, and a lot of turns where it's going to be, all right, let them go, they're faster than me, I'll catch them at this corner because I know I'm better there than they are.
Faster, harder, stronger. Well, Duca Bruno is going to be on the pole today, which seems very unfair. And Dejected Racer, former King of the Ring, is going to be in the second-to-last row. Kind of unexpected for him, although with the season he's been having, hopefully he'll be able to make up for it here. Speaking of, a lot of drivers who have done fairly bad actually will be doing fairly well here.
The thing about this track, it offers so much in terms of for each driver. Some drivers are so good here, and then they're just terrible at every other track. I think today's going to be a good race. We're going to see a lot of comers and goers, but I'm going to focus on that last corner. Coming out right there, because that's one where the race winner is going to be decided and where the championship's going to be decided as well. Because if you miss it and get on the gas too early, we'll go into the grass and possibly even hit the wall.
Fun little fact, it has been known that any driver who is in the first row tends to be the one who wins the race at the end. So, we're going to see what happens here today.
Starting on the pole is current points leader Duca Bruno. Alongside him, STI Cav.
In row 2, we have Flipside CRA Erebus and Zombie Panda.
Starting in row 3, on the inside, we have Zeta 0085. Next to him is, again, King of the Ring, Dejected Racer.
In row 4, we have points leader, well, second in points, I'm not going to say he's going to win the championship, I don't know, Fallen 215, and next to him, Bandit 1097.
Starting shotgun on the field is Roll Tide 424.
Alright, thank you very much, Windcharger. Let's get down to the action. Oh boy, here they go. It looks like Duca Bruno has got great launch with STI Kev in second place and Zombie Panda in third. And we see Fallen 215 cutting the grass trying to get through.
This long straightaway favors the Subarus on the start.
Well, in this case, Duca Bruno.
He's already got a sizable lead going into that first corner.
And it looks like Dejected Racer cut through the grass there, trying to avoid hitting people. And Fallen 215 is now caught up into the top three. He's right behind STI Kev for second place. And it looks like STI Kev went off the road there. A little bit of contact. Almost hit CRA Erebus. Roll Tide 424 is just kicking it back in the rear. And it looks like CRA Erebus is giving Zeta 0085 a nudge, trying to get past.
He's had contact with somebody, I don't know who, but oh!
Well, he just got his second victim, Zeta 0085, as they make their way through the turn. Looks like STI Cav's going to try to make the pass. Nope! Oh, there goes his car, along with CRA Erebus.
It's about 3 weeks in a row for CRA Erebus, flipped at Camino in Sebring, and now he's wrecked here.
And STI Kev has gotten his first flip out here at Nürburgring. As they make their way finally through the back and forth of the S's, they're now on the second straightaway here at Nürburgring. Looks like Bandit 1097 has moved up. He is currently, I believe, in fifth place at the moment.
Really fast corner right here. It's going to set you up for that third straightaway where there's a really hard braking point down at the end of it, and that's where you're going to see a lot of people try and make passes.
On board with Bandit 1097. It looks like he's drafting off of Zeta. He has the advantage here with his all-gripping Evo 8, as he's going to catch up right here. Zeta has it on the inside, and it looks like Bandit just gave him a love tap, giving him the heads up, hey, I'm right behind you.
Nothing wrong with a little tap. I mean, that's part of racing.
Sorry, go ahead.
You can expect that from anybody, really. I mean, I would do it. there goes Zeta.
Yep, he just... Oops, Zombie Panda followed in suit, too. I guess he shouldn't have been keeping an eye on where he's going. And it looks like Roll Tide has caught up. He's gone from last to catching up to the top five. He's right now on the heels of Bandit 1097 there for a sec.
Up to another heavy braking zone.
Looks like
a lot of passes can be made right here. Somebody goes way wide.
I think it was both CRA Erebus and STI Kev, as Zeta and Bandit are side by side for a second. And Roll Tide is catching right up there in that train. It's a Congo line here of freaking Evos. Evo 8, Evo 6, and an Evo 10. With Volta, who is right now behind Zeta 85. Another hard-breaking point. It looks like Zeta braked a little too late. He's going to give Volta the pass here. Or is he?
Here's one of the few calamity corners right here. Not this one that Volta and Zeta are going through, but this next one up here. If you get a wheel wrong, you will roll your car.
I've yet to see any drivers in previous championships actually flip over. There is one particular spot on the Nürburgring, but that's quite a ways up. It'll be some time before the second carousel. I'll make sure to point it out when we get there. And in the back of the field, we see some action between CRA Erebus and Dejected Racer. Looks like Dejected Racer decided not to paint or pretty up his Evo 10.
I was actually watching practice, and actually, Dejected Racer had a massive crash, had to bring out the backup car, which unfortunately was not painted.
I guess you could say this is his backup Evo 10. One thing about Dejected Racer is he's a very conservative driver as of late. I know he used to pull a little bit of what Duca Bruno did when he was a more active driver in the 2010 season.
One moment that stands out to me from Dejected Racer is his run here in one of the previous DTM championships. He won that race here.
And CR Erebus, sorry to cut you off there, almost went on two wheels again. Third time's a charm here.
That car, I can tell, is on a razor's edge. Third time's a charm. He'll roll it the next time he does it, probably.
Supposedly, I've seen some drivers roll up on the carousel.
All the while, Duca Bruno's enjoying a comfortable lead.
Yep. Fallen 215, on the other hand, is trying to catch up here. Now, if the race were to end specifically at this spot, looking at the point standings, Duca Bruno would already be the winner. Now, I'm not saying it's too early to say he's going to win, because we still have a good stretch of Nürburgring to finish.
Anything can happen. You're not out of the woods until you cross the finish line for the checkered flag.
I remember during the Porsche Championship, Duca Bruno participated with the for the first time. At Silverstone, he actually got his Porsche on two wheels, almost flipped it over, and managed to go through, I think it was Stowe, on two wheels for about 10 seconds. It was probably the scariest and most funniest part of the championship that year. Yes. Now we're going to have to what is nicknamed Skyline Drive. It was during the 2010 R34 Championship that Fallen 215 and SCI Cab are battling out for the lead. Fallen 215 cuts the grass, gets onto the rumble strip, gets on two wheels, flips the car over, and stays upside down for the remainder of the race. We had to get a tow truck to his car. That was probably a very disappointing time for him.
No word from race officials. Duke of Bruno under given a warning for cutting the track right there.
Will it affect him in the points? I'm not sure. And here it is, the last turn coming to Nürburgring before he hits the straight here.
If he can keep it between the paint, he's got this championship in the bags. Congratulations, Duke. I guess we can say now, congratulations, Duke of Bruno, on your 2013 STI Championship.
And right behind him in second place will be Fallen 215 for Team Evo. Coming into third will be Bandit 1097, followed by Roll Tide 424. Wow. It's over. The 2013 Evo STI Championship has ended.
I'm hoping for a photo finish to kind of decide this championship, but hey, I mean, Duke of Bruno ran one hell of a race, and not only just one hell of a race, one hell of a season from Bruno. I mean, what can you say?
I'm pretty sure everyone else is kind of getting an idea of what you said, and I was going to say you also gave the drivers a run for their money. Starting from the pole, did not wreck, although he did cut some corners here and there. He managed to win the championship and get another win. Alright, let's take a look at the unofficial results for today at Nürburgring. Wow, I'm just fumbling over my words. Duke of Bruno gets one win. Duke of Bruno gets first place. The race officials have not penalized him. Fallen 215 gets second place. Bandit 1097 rounds out third.
Roll Tide 424 gets fifth, and CRA Erebus came back from a wreck early on, finishing the top five. Behind him was Zeta 0085.
And I'm just going to cut in real quick. He just said Roll Tide finished fifth. It was actually fourth. Yeah. Dejected Racer had his best finish, seventh place, followed by STI Kev, who unfortunately flipped his car over and then some.
And last but not least, rounding out the field is Zombie Panda.
An unfortunate ending to Zombie Panda. I know he was looking forward to getting into the top three here at Nürburgring. As for the manufacturer standings, Team Evo has dominated with 582 points. Team Subaru, 499. Oh, yes, and before I forget, the final standings of the 2013 EVO STI Championship. I've already said it 100 times, Duke of Bruno is our champion with 153 points. Fallen 215, second place with 150 points. Roll Tide finishes in third with 136. Bandit 1097 was 4 points behind with 132. Z085 rounds out the top 5 with 109 points. CRA Erebus, who has had a very on-and-off season, gets 6th place with 106 points. STI Kev is in 7th with 98 points. Zombie Panda was 2 points behind with 96. And Dejected Racer, who had an okay start and a decent finish, gets last place with 86 points.
Overall, I think one successful season. Duke to Nürburgring. 5 races, 1 champion, well, 2 champions, got the manufacturer, I do. Can't wait till the next championship goes on, and I'm actually hoping to be a part of that one.
Well, if things work out accordingly, we should be scheduled for the Chevy Cobalt SS Cup. Looks like Division 1 is going to be pretty full, not too sure about Division 2. We'll have to see what happens for that. And Windcharger, I'm hearing that you might be able to participate. Hopefully we'll see you there for all 5 races coming up.
I hope so as well. I got a pretty good HP Invent Chevy Cobalt, and looking forward to running all five races. Hopefully we don't have another Suzuka.
Well, if we do, you're always welcome to join us here in the studio. And if you want, you can always just hop right out of the car after the first division and just come in here and share your experiences when we get ready for Division 2.
Much appreciated, KRX. I'd like to do that if I could.
And unfortunate that Italia was no longer able to join us for the last three races. I understand that being a soccer announcer is definitely a career for him. So hopefully we'll be seeing him again soon.
Not in the booth, maybe out on the track or out on the field.
Any final words you want to share with us, Wind Charger, before we cut the cord here?
All I'm going to say is, even after one hell of a season, I mean, I know there's drivers out there disappointed, but I mean, we all can take something away from this. Even if you could finish first, last, it don't matter. As long as you had fun. I had fun up here in the booth, and I can't wait to do another one.
All right, folks, this has been KRX and second-in-command Wind Charger. We'll look forward to seeing you for the upcoming Chevy Cobalt race. Take care, and see you soon.